C1 fractures are caused by high-speed injuries, usually caused by axial loading on the spine. In this video, we will discuss the C1 fracture and the classification, the management, and the imaging. I am Mohamed Raz, and this is your knowledge platform for the brain, spine, and beyond. C1 fracture represents around 7% of the cervical fractures. It can be seen in the adults, especially with high-energy axial loading, like diving into the sea or the swimming pool, or in an elderly group where they have a low energy fall, like falling from on the stairs or from the bed. The mechanism of injury can be different. This could be either hyperextension or lateral compression or axial compression. And the mechanism of injury will dictate what type of fracture of the C1 will happen. With axial loading, this will cause burst of the C1. With an axial loading and rotation, this will cause a lateral mass fracture. With an axial loading and flexion, this will cause an anterior arch fracture. With an axial loading and extension, that will lead to a posterior arch fracture. The C1 fracture can be classified into three types. This is the Landel's classification or the Jefferson classification. Type 1 fracture, when you have a fracture through the anterior arch or the posterior arch of C1. Type 2, which is basically the Jefferson type fracture, where always remember this as you have a 4-point fracture. So it's a fracture through the anterior and posterior arch having 4 points of fracture. And then type 3 fracture, where we have a fracture through the lateral mass of C1. Then there's another classification, which is Gilwire classification, which divided this into 5 types of C1 fracture. The type 1, as you can see here, where there is a fracture through the anterior arch of C1. Type 2, where you have a fracture through the posterior arch of C1. And then type 3, which is divided into A and B, where you have a fracture through the anterior and posterior arch of C1. Type A, where you have an intact, transverse atlantal ligament, or if that's disrupted, then that would be type B. Type 4, that would be a fracture through the lateral mass, and then type 5, where you have a fracture just through the transverse foramen. Most of the patients will get a CT scan as part of their trauma survey, but the C1 fractures, you can identify the C1, C2 kind of instability through the open mouth x-ray. Here, as you look into this image, you can see this is a normal open mouth view, where we have the lateral mass of C1 hanging kind of on top of the C2. I just wanted to show you this so that you can appreciate the abnormality with the next picture. And what we do here is basically trying to look for the C1, C2 overhang, and you need to measure how much overhang in between the C1 and C2. So if we see the C1 here, again, that's the C2. That's a C1, that's a C2. The distance, if we draw a line like this, and we draw a line like this, and again, this line and this line, this space here, let's say it's X, and this space is Y, the combination of that should be less than 7 millimeters. Here in this image, this means that there's an overhang. This is very important. What does that mean? Because it means that there's a disruption of the transverse atlantal ligament, then this overhang is happening. And this is again shown in this picture, where you see the disruption here, or the fracture of the C1, and this is the space in between kind of the C1, C2 overhang. And if you remember, as I said earlier, the classification which shows the type 3 fracture into type A and type B, 3A and 3B, the 3B have been kind of subclassified by Deckman into 2 types, relying on the transverse atlantal ligament. If the transverse atlantal ligament is completely disrupted, then that would be type B1. And if it's the ligament is intact, but there is avulsion of a piece of the bone from the C1 with the ligament, then that would be type 3B2. MRI scan can be used, as you know, to identify those ligamentous structures and soft tissue injury and any associated spinal cord injury. The treatment of C1 fractures is likely to be non-surgical. Most of the patients will be treated in a collar with follow-up x-rays. Some patients might require halo, like patients who have type 3 injuries. And fixation might be required if there is a severe disruption of the transverse atlantal ligament and there is a big concern about the spinal instability. Let's have a look on some of the imaging. So as we can see in this patient here, this is an axial view. As we're going down, you can see this is the odontoid peg and this is the C1 arch. We can see here a fracture through the anterior arch on the right side, going all the way down. Again, that extends all the way down. So it's likely just it's fractured probably through one side. Again, if we look through the coronal imaging, and if we go all the way here, you can see there's a fracture line there on the right side, as I said. And again, this is pretty much the same as the open mouth view I mentioned earlier, and you can appreciate the amount of C1, C2 overhang, which you can see on the coronal image of CT. So it's not essential that you do the x-ray. Again, if we go on the sagittal view, again, you can appreciate there is a fracture here through the arch of C1. This is another patient where this is kind of a typical Jefferson fracture type 2. And if we go here, you will find that this patient has, there is 2 points of fracture here through the anterior arch. And posteriorly, again, there is 2 points of fracture through the posterior arch. And if we see the coronal image, this one is more obvious where you can see the C1, C2 overhang. Here the space is much, much bigger than the previous imaging that we have seen. And you can see the overhang is definitely more than 7 millimeter. And that means that there is likely here, there's a disruption of the ligamentous structures. And again, here on the sagittal imaging, you can probably appreciate the same amount of dislocation that's happening or displacement happening between C1 and C2. I hope you enjoyed this video and stay tuned for the next one. See you.